Good morning, everyone. If we could all take a moment for silence, take our seats. Our services are about to begin. Thank you. Please stand.
I welcome you to the Catholic community of Pleasanton. Please turn around as we begin with the reception of our brother. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God our Father and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, our brother Robert Grubbs died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with them eternal glory.
Of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them, they turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. Speak my word to them, whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will Lord, if you reach me,
My brothers and sisters, we believe that the ties and bonds of love and affection which bind us closely together throughout our lives do not unravel with death. Confident that God always remembers the good that we have done, let us bring our brother Robert to God's faithful and merciful hands. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Robert, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. Very shortly, we shall be listening to a proclamation of our first reading. We do have extra masks in the back for those who do not have masks, and we kindly ask you to put them on. We invite our first reader to come and proclaim our first reading.
You're reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men, indeed, they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with the elect. The word of the Lord.
The Lord is
was kind and merciful. The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is kind and merciful. Slow to anger, rich in kindness. The Lord is kind and merciful. Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my being. Bless God's name. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Forget not all God's blessings. The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is kind and merciful. Slow to anger, rich in kindness. The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, full of kindness. God is good to all creation, full of compassion. The Lord is kind. The Lord is kind and merciful. The goodness of God is from age to age, blessing those who choose to love, and justice toward God's children on all who keep the covenant. The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is kind and merciful. Slow to anger, rich in kindness. The Lord is kind and
reading from John 7 through 1. Dear friends, let us love one another because love comes from God. Whoever loves is a child of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. And God showed his love for us by sending his only Son into the world so that we might have life through him. This is what love is. It is not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the means by which our sins
are forgiven. This is the word of the Lord.
Listening, speak your words of wisdom, for the words you speak are everlasting life. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you, and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I thank you very much, those of you who are not part of the family, for being here, for coming to support Mary and Dave and the family. As the family today wants us to celebrate Robert's life. And that is what this whole Mass is going to be about, the celebration of his life. We actually began doing that at the very beginning when I received our brother into the church in which the family is no stranger. And that moment was meant to remind you and me of the day that David and Mary brought Robert to a church just like this, when they brought him for the sacraments of initiation. They were received into the community of faith as we received our brother at the door. And then he was baptized with water, giving him sanctifying grace, making him a part of the family of believers, the family of God. And that is the symbolism of the sprinkling right at the door. When we said in baptism he died with Christ, may he now share with him eternal glory. That was the desire, that is the desire of God for all of us. The procession into the church, And the procession, when we leave, is also going to symbolize the life that Robert lived, that he came from God and he returns to the Maker. And we had the family dress him up. This is more than just a fancy piece of cloth on this casket. This is the funeral pall, which is symbolic of the baptismal garment. 50-some years ago, Mary and David went shopping and bought little Robert a fanciful garment on the day of his baptism. And when he was baptized, the priest did make an allusion to that bright garment. He says, "You have now been clothed with Christ. See in this bright garment the outward sign of your Christian dignity." We are celebrating the life of a child of God. And then on that very day of their baptism, they were given a light. And that light was lit from that candle, which is the Paschal candle. And it is a very powerful symbol for Roman Catholics. That candle is lit on the holiest day of our year, that is the eve of Easter, in a church that is dark. And when the candle is lit for the very first time from a fire lit inside the church, the priest or the celebrant says, "Christ, our light and our salvation," and the congregation says, "Thanks be to God." It was from that candle that a little candle was lit and given to Mary and David and the godparent of Robert. And they were exhorted, "Keep this light burning brightly, because this child has been enlightened by Christ. He should walk as a child of the light." That is, again, God's dream and a desire, that we, like the moon, reflect the light of the sun. And the light of the Son of God, who is symbolized in that Paschal candle. As I listen to the stories about Robert, I have wished that I would have known him in life. Today, as we celebrate this life, I thought about the movie Cooley High, probably 45 or 46 years ago when I first came out. The story of high school friends who experience the ups and downs of life, I believe, in Chicago. And towards the end, there is a tragedy of one of them dying. And so they go to the cemetery to commit his body to the earth. And then there is a beautiful song at the end of that movie. "How do I say goodbye to what we've had? The good times outweigh the bad." I pray that, and I hope the family probably relates to that, that in life there are ups and downs, but there are so many good things for them to celebrate today. Our first reading today reminded us of the reason for our celebration today, and that is the love of God. The love of God in which everything starts. We would not be here if God is not love. Because it is the love of God that is so uncontainable that God has to be a community, a family, to share that love between Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And it was not enough for God to just share that love in that community of the Trinity, but wanted to share that love with each and every one of us. Our creation came out of this love. And so today we celebrate the love that gave to this family, Robert. And we have to be grateful to the source of all blessings, to the source of blessings who is God. Thanking him for the life that he gave to Robert. I would imagine we all would have wanted him to stay around a lot longer. But the life was cut short. It should not make us ungrateful for the blessings that Robert received in this short life. You who knew him have so many memories, and I know that some of those memories we will share as we continue to celebrate his life. But one of the things that I heard in the life that Robert lived is that he had a chance in this life to fulfill his passions. And as I heard that the story of his life, it reminded me of the Enneagram, which is one of the tools of psychological personality types. And it reminded me of the fourth type, which is the person that may not be very well understood by society at large because they live life on their terms. They stand out, they are usually artists, and their passion is how they live their lives. And I would imagine that Robert may have had that artist in him. So today we celebrate the blessings, the fact that he was able to fulfill his passions, to do the things that he wanted to do. But one of the things that the family said is he wanted to give the best of himself. And I thought I remember that line very well, that even when he was not feeling his very best, he desired to do the best for others. And that reminds me of a line I always remind those who come to the Sacrament of Reconciliation, sometimes feeling very bad that they are falling into the same pattern over and over again. And I always remind them that all God wants of us is to do our best and to leave the rest to the merciful and loving parent. And if I heard very well that Robert had that quality in him to give of himself and to give the best, we are very grateful. We are grateful for all of those that loved him, for the family from which he came, for the parents that gave him life and gave him their values, their culture, their faith. Thank you for giving him the best you had. Thank him for the brothers, for the uncles, the aunties, the nephews and nieces, and for his son. God was loving. And God blessed him in so many ways. Our readings today remind us, and I believe and I pray that Mary and Dave, on a very difficult time, grieving the life that is cut short, that the words of the gospel today will bring you healing and consolation, because those who mourn in the gospel today are called blessed. May you find healing and comfort in God. And may you find comfort in the words of that first reading that we heard today. The souls of the just are in God's hands, and no torment shall touch them. They seem in the view of the foolish to be dead. They are going from us was thought utter destruction, but they are in peace. That thought that Robert now rests in the hands of God, the God who loved him into this life, the God who loved him with this family, the God who loved him with the gifts and the talents and the passions that he had, the thought that he is lying in those hands, I think I should bring us comfort. There is no better place to be than in the hands of the Maker himself. And so may our brother rest in peace. And again, that song in that movie, Coolie High, there was a moment where it says, and I will take with me the memories to be my sunshine after the rain. I pray that there are many memories for you to remember, for you to smile about. And I pray that as we continue to celebrate this life, we will share some of those memories. May he be at peace. May you be at peace. Let us rise and pray. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of God, interceding for the church. Confident God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord, we join our prayers to his.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for those who feed others. May all your people, Lord, have daily nourishment. Let all be satisfied. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
May all who use and share their talents and gifts draw us closer and bring us to the family table of the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Give those who have an illness the courage and strength to fight another day, and grant us the grace to use our heart to reach out with help and support. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the souls of Bob's grandparents, Eleanor, Jack, Ed, and Helen, his uncles, Richard, Tom, Martin, and Joe, and his aunt, Frances, who preceded him in death, may they all welcome him home into the fullness of a life that never ends. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the whole church, that we prepare worthily for the hour of our death when God calls us home. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. May the prayer of those who cry to you benefit the souls of us, your servants, O Lord. Free them, we pray, from all their sins and make them sharers in your redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. Oh, Master, grant that I may never see so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Robert, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for you are faithful, Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. So the angels and archangels with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Please kneel. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that it may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For in the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate a memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy and entire people you have gained for your own. Listen, gracious, to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Robert, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, to all those who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kindness to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when we wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us pray as Jesus our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Brothers and sisters, for communion, even if you are not Catholic, we welcome you to come for a blessing if you so desire it. And the way that we recognize that you only want a blessing is by placing your arms across your chest, and we'll be happy to give you a blessing. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Jesus, who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Has not seen, ear has not heard what God has ready for those who love Him. Spirit of love, come give us the mind of Jesus. Teach us the wisdom of God.